Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. The research project, Innovation in Society, Training Path and Human Capital Enhancement in Sudan, INSO, it has been realized by the National Research Council of Italy, Institute for Research on Innovation and Services for Development, in partnership with Comboni College of Science and Technology in Khartoum, the Ministry of Higher Education and Scientific Research of the Republic of Sudan, and Centro Servizi di Ateneo per l'Apprendimento Permanente, University of Bari, under the patronage of Italian Embassy in Khartoum, Italy in Sudan, and the Sudanese Embassy in Rome. INSO project has been funded by Italian Ministry of Interior. In the current historical phase of transition, the INSO project supports innovation, knowledge transfer, and promotes socioeconomic development in Sudan, in particular through the creation of local job opportunities. The training course involves 140 undergraduates in computer science and information technology students from Sudanese University and to the Ministry of Education of Sudan and professors in Sudanese universities. Sudan is a country of origin, transit, and destination of migratory flows. The inadequate socio-economic development, coupled with intense demographic growth, present a great challenge for the country. General objective of the INSO project: to contribute to the socio-economic development of Sudan by supporting the training of young people, their empowerment to create employment possibilities, and their professional development. And now, specific objectives: to provide the addresses with the know-how related to knowledge, capabilities, and skills in the fields of computer science and information technology, to train university lecturers or staff who work in the field of professional orientation, and some staff members of the Ministry of Higher Education and Scientific Research of the Republic of Sudan to have the necessary skills to link the local universities with entrepreneurial and administrative sectors, to activate an effective dialogue between the agents involved in order to stipulate convention to provide the students with practical experience in Sudan. The first part with the English selection test, in total 140 students, formative modules for 140 students and two lecturers of Comboni College of Science and Technology and four staff members of the Ministry of Higher Education, where in Khartoum, Naples, Bari, and online. Formation for teaching professional orientation staff and Ministry of Higher Education, WU, in Naples, in Bari. For example, analysis of territories, methodologies for local development, social innovation. And now the theoretical contents for students. Sustainable development, a multidimensional concept. For example, job search techniques, preparation of a job interview, elaboration and presentation of a personal project.
And now I want to show you some elements about learning environment. The training courses were delivered in blended mode through seminars and lectures in presence in Sudan and through the support of e-learning platform Moodle and the learning setup managed by the Center for Lifelong Learning of the Aldo Moro University of Bari Resource. Among the resources made available by the platform, the course has made use of video lectures, additional material on PDF and conceptual maps to convey the knowledge in a perspective of self-training, assignment and quizzes to evaluate the acquired knowledge and skills, forum and chats, facilitating dialogue and community building between the students. The training offering is composed by 6 didactic modules. The first is building micro enterprises, the second is organization sustainability, the third is marketing and management, the fourth is social network and relationship dynamics, the 5 is job search technique, and the 6 is social media for micro enterprises. About the registered students, the project envisaged the involvement of 114 students. 47 of them did not have a personal email address. As a consequence, only 103 students were involved in this project. Among them, 16 students have never accessed the platform and have never benefited from the training provided. Therefore, the training activities were carried out by the 84% of the eligible students. In other words, by 187 students out of the 103 registered on the platform. And about the participation, 73 video lectures were uploaded on the platform. They have registered an average of 217 views for video lesson. The individual study was also supported by in-depth materials in PDF and concept maps. A total of 102 resources were loaded, each of which was displayed 187 times on average. Within the forums, a lively comparison has been generated. There are in fact 2,057 speeches and, including the chat, 40,215 views. About the educational guidance to individual studies, study and analysis of the teaching material provided as a part of educational program, creation of contextual maps for each module of the training offer, conceptual maps created via the Mindomo software, and about a questionnaire for the assessment of apprenticeships. 3 multiple choice questions were generated for each module for a total of 18 questions, aimed to create a final questionnaire administrative of the specific platform use. The aim is to verify the levels of knowledge achieved. This questionnaire is structured in accordance to various levels of evaluation, allowed to achieve a sufficient evaluation by answering positively a minimum of 6 questions out of a total of 18, a good evaluation for 7 to 12 correct answer, and an excellent evaluation for 13 to 18 answer. From the foregoing analysis, it can be seen that 50 students actually completed the test, and in particular that 22 of them obtained a good evaluation, while 28 obtained an excellent evaluation. And about soft skill acknowledgement, assessment and certification, the aim is to involve the project's target audience in the soft skill assessment process. But which soft skills, career development skills, competencies that support the individual in identify his or ability skills, developing professional learning objectives, and making career decision. And about the skill under investigation, the self-assessment competencies that analyze the self-analysis capacity of the skill and the resources possessed by the individual, a career awareness competencies that analyze the user's awareness of their own skills and the gaps that need to be developed for career purposes, the goal-setting competencies analyze the ability to identify and define the goals to achieve the action, determination, and problem-solving capabilities of the individual. The skill development competencies analyze the individual ability to perform action in pursuit of self-development, and career management competencies that analyze the individual ability to plan appropriate action in accordance with the resources at his or her disposal toward profitable management of his or her career. And about the methodology, the five subdimensions have been analyzed in three steps through three tools and summarized in an individual folder: the competence, the assessment steps, and the folder. And about the tool, we work about self-evaluation survey, about career development competencies assessment, the soft skills of evaluation task, and the student's career development skill assessment. It's interesting to have an idea of the process. We're starting from tool design, testing issues, data analysis, and folder process. And about outputs, career development skills, individual profiles. In this document, was composed by a synthesis graph showing the result of the investigation of the competence investigated, an individual profile, the description of career development skills, and also some recommendation. About the purpose and evaluation criteria, the questionnaire aimed to evaluate the effectiveness of the training project, compare it to expected objective with the result obtained through three evaluation criteria. First of all, is student satisfaction with the usefulness of the course, customer. The second is evaluation of learning in terms of self-perception, is a form of a self-assessment. And the third is transferability, the impact on working career. About the attendees, 83, the three tests were not collected for all the participants, and I was just to show you some dates that I think that it's interesting about the percentage. The first of all is usefulness of the course. Do you think that the objective of the module have been achieved? And the major percentage is in on job search technique, on the marketing and management, or social media for micro enterprises. And the topic covered in the module have been useful for your study and job search. In this slide, job search technique is the most interesting, social networks and the relationship dynamic is the second, and the third is marketing and management. What would you improve in the module between educational content and the distance learning? And educational content is in a major percentage about remote delivery. About the perception of learning, how much do you think you have improved your learning on the issues covered by the training compared to before the start of the project? And if you consider that for the 65% is a lot, is enough for 32, and it's a little just for a percentage of 3%. Do you feel more confident in managing content related to training topics than before the start of the project? Is a lot for 56%, is enough for 41%, and is a little just for 3%. And when we're thinking of a future job, you think you have the ability to achieve the objective assigned, respect working hours and times, learning new work methods, concentrate your energy on the job, complete the task assigned, relate effectively with any customers, have a good relation with managers, working with people who have different in age and experience from mine, working in group and collaborate with other colleagues. How much do you think perception of work efficiency has improved after the course? Confidence related to your skill is a lot for 71%. You had the opportunity to use the knowledge learned in some university tests or in some professional experiences. Is enough for 19% and a lot for 18%. Which modules do you think will make it easier for you to find a job? First of all, job search technique, microenterprises creation, marketing and management, and social media for microenterprises. And about the attendance age, the context is that we have a lot of people that have 20, starting from 23 years, 21 years old, 42 years old, but the percentage of the older people is less. Thank you so much for your attention.
This third part of our presentation, we are going to present the conclusions from the perspective of Sudan. Among the positive outcomes for Kumbuni College of Science and Technology, I would underline, first of all, the increase or the improvement in the quality of the internships. Before the project, two lecturers of the college were following up these internships of the students, but they were the students, those supposed to identify the institution to make the internship and then present in the proposal to the lecturer that should approve. Now, instead, after the project, these two lecturers draft conventions with the companies so that objectives, duration, conditions are defined and the quality of the internships is improved. Some of the students of the project have been engaged by the companies where they did the internships during the INSO project. I would like to underline the case of two South Sudanese refugee students that have been engaged by Khartoum College of Applied Sciences, and one South Sudanese refugee student who has become the IT director of Regency Hotel, a very important hotel in the center of the city. Other positive outcome of the project for us has been the creation of a new Bachelor of Science in Information Technology that benefits from the experience of the project by incorporating subjects like entrepreneurship, information technology, sustainability and social responsibility, and the concept of circular economy and triple bottom line in the respective subjects like economics, for instance. The fourth positive outcome of the project, and maybe the most remarkable one, has been the creation of a startups incubator. Part of the funds of the INSO project were used for the purchase of the necessary equipment. And this is also the result of the conclusions of the project, but also the desire of the students. 77% of them would like or wished to start their own business, but they face problems like the lack of capital, according to them, and the lack of know-how. In our perception, the lack of know-how is more meaningful than the lack of capital, but for them, the main problem is the lack of capital. In any case, the incubator that already started in June 2019, this year, The formative or the training program is divided into three stages. The first one, pre-incubation, provides with the basic tools to start a business, especially thinking of incubators coming from the ICT sector. So it provides with tools like how to make the necessary tools to produce a marketing plan, a business model. And so we started with 20 incubators. Most of them did the INSO project. This group should finish its formation in November. And after that, they will enter the second stage, incubation, where they will have mentors to apply or to develop their business idea or also the prototype. At the end of the incubation stage, they can apply for funding. And among the criteria we have to select the projects that will be funded, we give priority to those projects that meet a social need or have the capacity to create jobs, and also especially those that will be located in the marginalized zones of the metropolitan area of Khartoum. The incubator is now sponsored by a local company called JTI that gives the necessary money for the running expenses for the first year and has already expressed its willingness to support the second and the third year. But the idea is that with the a certain percentage of the income of the future incubated companies, the incubator may become self-sufficient. Other conclusions from the project, or some recommendations for future e-learning training programs, is something that maybe is not so obvious in Europe, like the difficulty to use an email account that is not so evident for students here in Sudan. Then, in a project like this that involves different universities, there is need of identifying a tutor in every university that may follow the journey of the students of that university. And also considering the access problems, we saw so important the fact of having a computer lab where the students can have access to internet and share their problems with a tutor. As for the limits of the research that can be done on the project, it's still early to see the percentage of employability of the ESO students and compare that percentage with the one of similar students that did not do the project.